De eerste herfststorm is uitgeraasd. De bossen rond de Lage Vuurse, waar wij Friso in augustus naar zijn laatste rustplaats brachten, liggen er weer vredig bij. Zo ook is bij mij de eerste storm van woede en onmacht langzaam aan het overtrekken. De scherpste randjes van de rouw zijn aan het afstompen. De wond begint de eerste tekenen van genezing te tonen. Al kan ik in de verste vette nog niet overzien hoe het litteken uiteindelijk met mij zal vergroeien. Stilte na de storm. Tijd om te herdenken wie Friso was en ook te vieren wie Friso is. Friso als broer, Friso als familieman. It's gonna be a wonderful day tomorrow, zei hij, kijkend naar de heldere sterrenhemel boven de Alpen op de avond van 16 februari. Hij nam afscheid van een paar kennissen waarmee hij een drankje had gedronken. Ze waren onder de indruk van het evenwicht dat hij scheen te hebben bereikt in zijn leven. De balans tussen het gezin waar hij helemaal gek op was, zijn baan en ook alles wat hij professioneel en op maatschappelijk gebied op jonge leeftijd al had bereikt. Dat die prachtige tijd samen met zo'n dreun voor ons allen zou eindigen, was onvoorstelbaar. En is dat soms nog steeds.
Our father was a wise man. An independent mind. With big ideas. And a strong passion for people. He admired Friso. His numeric brain. His loyalty and independence. His strength and, of course, his golf. They had much in common, and it's a pity that he didn't get a chance to see how Friso followed in his footsteps as honorary chairman of his loved Prince Claus Fund for Culture and Development. These were not the subjects that we used to associate the young Friso with, but he grew into it and greatly contributed to the fund's success. In our first year at the fund, it decided to pick up on a rather ridiculously ambitious but brilliant idea of our late father, an opera for the Sahel. It was to be a monument to celebrate the rich cultural traditions of the Sahel in poetry, in storytelling, music, and dance. And this opera was indeed written, produced, and performed by people from at least 4 Sahel countries. It toured Africa, to Bamako, Ouagadougou, it came to Amsterdam, performed in Paris, and today in Delft, where Yves and Carlo D from the original cast will perform for us.
Parinant, Akasore. Now, Friesel had an unusual broad range of interest, because how many of us study mechanical engineering, then aeronautical engineering, then economics, then business administration, and a few Leiden subjects on the side, as someone observed, each a carefully considered choice. How often does one meet a man of 44 years old who has already proved himself a promising management consultant, an accomplished investment banker, a dedicated investor, and a surprisingly people-engaged chief financial officer? There was a strategy behind his wide-ranging education and his stellar career. Friso tried to build on each experience. And in addition, on the side, he had a real passion for breakthrough insights at the crossroads of science, society, and business. And he pursued his career while he kept a keen eye on practical applications ranging, already referred to MRI, to aerospace, to renewables. Over the years, as Friso built his career, we talked about choices in both professional and in his private life and the role of luck. His view was very simple. Luck is the bridge between the known and the uncertain future. And luck, he said, cannot be counted on. Nothing in the future can be taken for granted. He believed strongly in the power of education, already referred to a moment ago, and everybody's right to access education. And in his view, this implied the duty to study very hard to achieve independence. Yes, and indeed, he was a strong believer in meritocracy, which, given his background, may seem both odd and not so. Unpretentious and dedicated, Friso was very aware of his privileged parcours based on a lucky birth in a warm family. He felt a duty to make the most of it, but also to prove himself independently of it. He built on this solid platform as a source of inspiration to set and reset his own goals, while clearly cherishing his family linkages and mentioning that all the time. His parents can be proud of how they educated him. Now, several years ago, we walked through the crowds at the World Economic Forum in Davos. And Friso, who was there as partner of, which was a status which he loved, Friso suddenly said, "What a strange period in which well-educated people increasingly measure each other and themselves by their image." And he added, a word he loved, "sometimes by their Mickey Mouse ideas, rather than by their actual accomplishments and luck." In contrast, I'm convinced that Friso's own sole ambition was to do, not to be.
So as we leave this memorial to our dear friend and a unique person, let's not focus on a shared loss. Let's focus on keeping a piece of a friend alive. First, by realizing that life's precious and it can be short. But let us also push ourselves in the way that Friso used to do. Let us think independently. Let us listen before we talk. Let us help a friend who has a question. Let us question the question before we come with the answer. And let us take action when we believe in a cause. Let us aim to make a difference without feeling the need to put ourselves in the center of the picture. Let us challenge ourselves and each other to think differently. Let us think big. And then let's combine all of that with a twist, with a little bit of humor. So let us today, each of us, take a bit of the Friso as we knew him well away with us in our lives going forward. Let's create this pedestal for Friso. And if we think we've been successful, let's reward ourselves with that mischievous, satisfying Friso smile in memory of our dear friend.
Friso, he was very good in hiding his interest and love for dance. At least for most of his life. But maybe by Mabel's doing, he became very fond of the Nederlands Danstheater. And he found time to enjoy and support arts and culture. And with Mabel, he helped to set up a collaborative fundraising effort in London called the Dutch Masters to support the Nederlands Danstheater, the Mauritshuis Museum, and the Royal Concertgebouw Orchestra, three of the most prestigious cultural institutions of the Netherlands. He believed that people with wealth should give back to society. He also wanted to support Dutch interests whilst being abroad. So we've asked four Dutch masters to play for us as a tribute to Friso's and Mabel's efforts in this field.
We pray especially for his young family, for his extended family, for his relatives and friends. Help them to cherish his memory, to live life to the full.